Because when you aim, then definitely you will work hard and you will try and make sure that you achieve it. Probably, you know, if you aim for 95% and if you work towards it, definitely you might end up achieving, you know, probably 95% or definitely 80%. But if you keep your aims smaller, if you think that, you know, you want to get passing marks, you know, that is my aim, I just want to clear my MBA and get a degree, then probably you never know, you will get a passing mark or you might end up having backward turn. So the only thing I want to tell you is always aim big, then you will be probably be able to reach greater heights. I'm not saying that I have received so many things for this thing. It is just that whatever.
Because here, I think the lecturers were so good
and they carry so much of industrial experience and knowledge that will definitely, you know, help you in future. I'm telling you guys now itself, you might not agree to this. You might feel that this guy is coming and telling something, you know, like everybody has to help. But later part of my life, you know, have you guys heard your vice chancellor, P.S. Aitha? Have you guys heard his talk? How many of you enjoy his talk? Only two. Okay, rest of you don't enjoy. You feel like he just comes and closes his eyes and he talks, right? Okay. Jokes apart, to be frank, he is one of those persons. I think I'm hardly met across such people. He carries such immense knowledge and he is such a visionary that he will give you all the gap during his class. Because I think MBA is all about going out of syllabus. Till now, probably from your school, then your college degree, what you guys have done? You guys had syllabus, you studied that, and you know, you by going and writing the exam, passing with good numbers, and if you get good score, it is like a brilliant student, bright student, top student of the class, average student, just by seeing your marks. But do you think that is the actual parameter to gauge you, that are you a bright student, is it going to decide your future? No, I don't think so, because when I joined MBA, the only thing what I felt was, after listening to certain guest lecture, as I said, and the faculty members here, whenever they were giving their what that knowledge they carry, I always felt we are here to do something different. If we are, see, there are two things. You guys can come here, study, pass your exams and go with the post-graduation certificate. But is it going to add any value to your life? I don't think so. Because there are thousands of colleges who offers MBA and lots of students who come out every year passing with, holding the degree of post-graduation. Do everybody get a job they want? Are they all successful? Are they all not struggling in their life? No. Definitely, they are probably, this is a competitive world and you need to be top of everything. So what you guys can do for that? First thing, you need to stand out. So go out of syllabus. That is the topic which I want to discuss today. So going out of syllabus means, till now, as I said, you guys have studied, you guys have passed and you have come here. From now on, do one thing. Try and make sure that you encash the opportunity. So encash each and every opportunity that you get here. So first thing would be, whenever you get an opportunity to come here and stand and present something, don't hesitate. If you are hesitating now, you will hesitate for the rest of your life. Because you have to start someday. And now you guys have got these 2 years, this golden opportunity to make mistakes and learn from them. So come here and whenever you get that opportunity to, present the presentations, the topics which are given to you, make sure you are encashing that. And probably that only will help you to grow further, and that is going to be the best part in your life. You will definitely come out of that confidence, that fear, and you will come up with that confidence of facing people, public speaking. All this is something that MBA offers. And MBA is not only about your character, it's all about your skills that you can learn from it. Okay? Alright. Am I worried right now? Am I just talking and you guys are, I think some of them are already sleeping there. Alright, no problem. But so are you guys with me? Okay. Alright, so I want to, ask someone, if somebody could volunteer and tell me what are their plans, what they, how they see this MBA, and what are their expectations, and because you guys are in first year, So what do you want to become in future? What are your plans? Like how you see these 2 years and how you are preparing? I want to know from you guys. So can anybody volunteer and help? Anyone? I can see all of them on the outside. All of us. All right. Shall I pick someone and let's see. What's your name? Blue shirt. You, yes. Yes.
Corporate law, probably in the legal team of some companies,
or handling the PR related issues, public relations. So there are ample opportunities there. So, okay, so you have already kept that in mind. Is there any company or something that you have decided that you will probably try there? No. It's just that you want to complete this course and then try. Okay. Nice. Anybody else? Continue your business itself.
Yes.
You have a family owned business or something? You want to start off something of your
startup.
Okay. So for that you need that confidence and you have to learn the management skills.
Yes.
And that's what you want to do.
Yes.
Okay. Nice. Thank you. Okay. So, okay. I'm very happy that three of them stood up and they gave their viewpoints and why they aspire and what they aspire and why they are here. It's really great to know. Did you guys, I don't know what you guys learned from this, but what I understood from these three people is that all of them had different ideas and different ways of, ways for opting this MBA course. One wanted to do corporate lawyer's job or probably get into corporate management. And other has a unique idea of getting into a cruise and he has a hotel management. And you have an idea of doing a business of your own. And you want to, that was a very good point that you wanted to gain confidence and learn management skills. So MBA is that the course which will give you all of this. Only if you enhance that opportunity. See, now I asked many of you, but I could see all these many people who stood up. Who stood up and had that courage to tell them. Was it a difficult thing? So just to tell, what do you want to become in your life? Simple question. Very simple question. Like what do you want to become? Or why did you opt this course? There was nothing that I asked you, something from, some technical things. Or a question which you would need to refer and then answer. It was very simple, about you. So, here, two things to learn. One, how well we know ourselves. Do we know ourselves and do we have any idea what we are doing in our life? Or we are just going with the flow? And second thing, there are few people who have idea but they need right guidance through which they want to continue and grow further. So it's okay if you don't have an idea or you don't know now why you want to do this. But let me tell you, always start from now, whenever you get an opportunity to stand up and speak or somebody is asking your viewpoint, please make the best use of it, stand up and speak. It's okay if you make mistakes. I am not going to remember each one of you here. Probably somebody gives an exceptional answer of your, if you are giving something that actually if I get to learn something from it, I will definitely remember you, but otherwise I might not. Because we meet so many people in our life, even you guys. So if you don't know something, it's okay. Stand up and tell what you know, specifically when you're asked. So there was a difference. When I asked someone and when you guys volunteered yourself. So it's okay. Always be ready to face, no matter what. Because I'm sure after completing your MBA, you guys want to get into a job. How many of you want to get into a job? Raise your hand. I can see all of you want to get into a job. Nobody is saying that I will do MBA and I will sit at home. Correct? So is it that easy that you get a job after completing your MBA? Is it going to be very easy? You will go out in the market and you will apply the companies, you will sit there, interviewer will not ask anything and you will crack the interview. Is that going to happen? Definitely not. the world is very challenging out there.